leadership that is the problem of Africa. It has nothing to do with colonialism. We are colonized years ago. Today, it is African leaders that have turned Africa into a gigantic criminal enterprise.
His Excellency, Mr. Peter Obi, again, was in Anambra State. And you all know how he's always been received when he come on stage to speak. Talking about bad governance, talking about the problem in Africa and Nigeria to be precise, you will understand and agree with me that colonialism happened over 60 years ago and Nigerians were colonized by the Britain. In the colonialism era, we saw what happened in Nigeria and all African countries. Nigerians were colonized among other African nations, but the colonial masters left Nigeria long ago. When you talk about the independence, you know, given to African nations, you still argue that the colonial masters still have some shells when it comes to decision making politically, economically, and otherwise regarding African progress in democracy, you know, economic decisions and all of that. But here is what His Excellency Mr. Peter Obi have to say, that politics, bad leadership is a reason for Africa's backwardness, especially Nigeria, not colonialism.
Please, mine is just a remark. Your Excellency, our dear governor, and my dear brother, Professor Charles Soludo. Your Excellency and our own dear mother, we have spoken so well that all we can do today is to go back and reflect on that your wonderful speech. And I thank my dear elder brother for inviting you. Mine is a simple remark which will not take more than 2-3 minutes. And it's to thank you most sincerely for the honor of coming to Nigeria for this wonderful lecture. Excellency, my contribution, my little contribution to your speech is that the problem of Africa, problem of Nigeria, rests clearly on leadership. It is bad leadership that is the problem of Africa. It has nothing to do with colonialism. We are colonized years ago. Today, it is African leaders that have turned Africa into a gigantic criminal enterprise. And I'll give you an example. This university. I'll give you an example of the problem we face in our country. University. If you're employed here, you work hard for several years to be a professor. And if you're a professor in this university, your salary is 400,000 naira. And if they pay you without spending your money for 30 years, your salary will amount to 144 million, which is not up to what we used to buy a car for a legislator in Nigeria. That is the problem of Nigeria. That is the problem of Nigeria. That is number one. Number two, this university where you are, the overhead they give to the vice chancellor from federal government of Nigeria is about 10 million naira. So in 1 year, they will get about 120 million naira. They have over 500 professors, over 4,000 lecturers, over 40,000 students. They get 10 million naira, 120 million naira a year. So five of the universities like this will get about 600 million naira annually, which if you convert to dollar today, is about 500,000 naira. That is what we use to go to a meeting of United Nations for 1 week. It's unacceptable. That is the problem of Nigeria. That is the problem of Africa. We can afford to do that with less than 10%. So it's clearly on our distance. So I thank you for being part of this crusade. I'm sure our governor, every other person, we are part of this crusade. We must dismantle this criminality.
in totality with Mr. Peter Obi saying that colonial masters left us 60 years ago and it's now left for Nigerians and other African countries to take the bull by the horn and take decisions since you have been given independence. But when you look at some of our monetary policies, our fiscal policies, our politicians, you know, campaigning, even the 2023 election, let's come to think about this. The three candidates of Nigeria at the last concluded election, they all went to the United Kingdom, you know, Chartered House to give a briefing. Even the Independent National Electoral Commission chairman was there to, you know, confirm to the world leaders and the rest that the election was going to be credible. Excuse me. When you look at the United States of America, the election is coming sometime next year. I have not seen the presidential candidate of Donald Trump from the Republicans and even Joe Biden from Democrats going to, you know, the UK or even going to Germany or Italy or better still France to have any form of conversation regarding their elections. But we saw African presidents or aspirants to be the president of the country, you know, traveling all the way to the United Kingdom, you know, to give their take, the policies, you know. So most of those things are the things that some Nigerians, including myself, still believe that we are now in, you know, another form of recolonization of Africa. And you can see the Chinese moving in, the Russians moving in, and other parts of, you know, the other people are moving in order to, you know, bring to secure their interest in African soil. So are we having neocolonialism? It is something that is very obvious to the blind. But then Peter Obi have a different opinion, saying that colonial masters left Nigeria and it is bad leadership. If you look at critically, it is those same leaders that went out to have those deals and all those things. Some of those other African leaders, like one of the presidents of one of the African countries, talks about cutting ties, you know, all his foreign trips has been suspended as a result of, you know, cutting costs. But here in Nigeria, we don't do that. So if you look at bad governance, can we say literally that it is a cause of bad leadership, or it is just because our colonial masters are still making decisions for us? I'll leave this thing for you to have this conversation in the comment section. Please let us know, what do you think? Do you agree with His Excellency Mr. Peter Obi of his assertion that colonialism is no longer in place in Africa, but bad leadership is the reason why we're having bad economy, bad decision makings, and all of that? Thank you for watching.